Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the limit of a sequence. The sequence we're given in this particular problem is a sub n equals 2n divided by the quantity 5n minus 3. And the easiest way to find the limit of a sequence when we have a rational function like this or a fraction with n related to terms in both the numerator and the denominator is to divide through by n. So we're going to divide each term in both the numerator and the denominator by n. And when we do that, when we divide 2n by n, we'll get 2. When we divide 5n by n, we'll get 5. And when we divide 3 by n, we'll get 3 over n. And the reason that we do this is because we're going to try to find the limit of the sequence a sub n as n approaches infinity. And you can imagine that if we tried to plug in infinity when our function is in this state here, and we plugged in infinity for n here in the numerator and in the denominator, we wouldn't get anything too pleasant, because 2 times infinity is still going to be infinity, 5 times infinity is still going to be infinity, and you can see how it starts to become pretty ambiguous pretty quickly about what we're going to do. On the other hand, if we divide through by n such that we cancel n in this term in the numerator and the first term in the denominator, and we end up with an n here just in the denominator of this second term in our overall denominator, then if we take 3 over infinity, 3 over infinity is going to become 0. If you're confused about why that is, the way that I learned to remember it and just accept it was I would take 3 and divide it by like 1 million in my calculator, and you can see that it's a very, very, very small number. So 3 divided by a number larger than itself that's approaching infinity, this number in the denominator gets larger and larger and larger. When the denominator is larger, that means it's going to approach 0. So by dividing all of the terms through by n, we eliminate n's in the numerator of each term specifically, and we end up with an n just in the denominator of this singular term here. So once we get n's only in the denominators, and again, we're not talking about the denominator here, 5n minus 3, but the denominator of 2n, which right now is 1, the denominator of 5n, which right now is 1, and the denominator of 3, now see we have it in the denominator of this term 3 here, 3 over n. Once we do that, then we can plug in infinity and find the limit. So when we plug in infinity for n, right, the limit as n approaches infinity of this sequence, we'll get 2 over the quantity 5 minus 0. Because again, this term here, 3 over n, as n approaches infinity, is going to become 0. So obviously when we simplify that, the 0 is going to go away, and we'll see that the limit of our sequence is equal to 2/5. So anyway, I hope that video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one.